Ladies and gentlemen, right at the beginning, I would like to talk about the good and the less good news. The good news is that the Hungarian economy has achieved great success in recent years, and the less good is that we are far away from the end of the road. There is still a lot to do. Unemployment in Hungary fell to 3.5% in comparison to 12.5% in 2010, but economic growth exceeded 4% in the first half of this year. Wage raising programs take place, career programs are launched, and families with children can count on more and more support. But not only is the Hungarian economy developing, but it is also true for our B4 partners. Therefore, it can be stated that the Central European region today is the engine of the European growth. In order to achieve the Hungarian economic success, the high quality work of the Hungarian people and the government's economic policy were required. We have created an economic environment where foreign investors are welcome. Last year, 96 international investments came to Hungary through our investment agency, and in the first half of this year, there have already signed another 46 agreements, creating a total of 24,000 jobs in our country. Hungary has proven to be the ideal production country, and the next task is to become the most ideal research and development state. Thus, the government introduced that every company can deduct from its tax base the double of its research and development spending. We strengthen the technical and IT training, and we are building a regionally unique test ground for automotive innovations in Zalaegerszeg. The global economy came to a turning point where the conditions of competitiveness changed completely. In this new era, the success of national economies depends on the level of digitalization and innovation. Countries where startups feel comfortable will have the most success. We Hungarians know that we don't have many raw materials, we have no sea, we know the size and the characteristics of our country. For endless raw materials, we have Hungarian creativity and ingenuity, which are always available. It is a historic experience that if the Hungarians use their minds, they can compete in any race with success. In the period of digitalization and innovation, we are entered the competition by building on our intelligence, creativity, and expertise. Ladies and gentlemen, in addition, in Central Europe, there is competitive spirit and vital instinct working inside us. We are able to see areas of life, the gaps where great results can be achieved with an idea through invention and development. In Hungary, the number of startups are increasing year by year. Currently, there are between 1,000 and 1,500 of them. Most of the startups are part of the digital economy, responsible for 20% of Hungary's GDP and accounting for about 15% of the employed. Startups can represent the breakthrough point of the Hungarian economy, so supporting them is very important, of course, very important for the Hungarian government. In the course of digital well-being program in 2016, we also set up digital startup strategy, the primary goal of which is to strengthen cooperation, create a supportive business environment, and provide a targeted funding framework. Nowadays, we have many tools for developing startups. We have set up targeted capital funds, announced various tenders, and created a number of science and technology parks. The recent Hungarian presidency of B4 Cooperation was probably the most intense era of the B4's history. In a challenging European political environment, we have achieved many results together, and several joint projects have been launched under our presidency. An excellent example of this cooperation was the B4 Startup Force project in the field of innovation. Initiatives such as this reinforces and renews the strategic alliances between the B4 countries. If you look at what the participants of the B4 Startup Force program have implemented in the areas of commerce, healthcare, family planning, or corporate communications, we can be sure that these startups are worthy of our support, and we will hear a lot more about them. So I wish you great success for these businesses, for the program communicator design terminal, and for its foreign partners.